If you watched my last video, I talked about the major update that Adobe announced to Photoshop 2024, namely that they're bringing Firefly, which powers their Generative Expand and Generative Fill technologies, to all users of Photoshop, not just the Photoshop beta users. That's a really big deal. But there were a few other things that were announced that I wanted to cover in a separate video, namely having to do with changes to the Creative Cloud pricing and a new concept called Generative Credits, which will essentially limit you to how many Generative Fill or Generative Expand or text creations you use with Firefly, whether it's in Photoshop or the Firefly web app. So let me show you what I mean. So let's start with the pricing changes because there are a few things to talk about. First and foremost is that the changes will not take effect until November 1st, 2023. At the time of recording, we're in the middle of September, so we still have about 6 weeks to go. It's also important to know that this won't affect every single Creative Cloud subscriber. The way I can see it, it's pretty much affecting if you are subscribing to an individual app like Premiere Pro, or you are subscribing to the All Apps plan. Now, what's kind of good news, especially for subscribers to this channel, is that if you are a Creative Cloud Photography plan subscriber, these changes should not affect you. Same goes if you are subscribing to just the Lightroom plan, you should be good to go, at least for the time being. Now, in terms of pricing increase specifics, it depends on a few things. Obviously, it depends on which plan you're subscribed to. So for example, if you're subscribed to one of the individual single app plans and you pay Adobe month to month, but on a year contract, your price will go up $2. For those same customers who pay month to month without an annual plan, you'll pay $3 more. And then if you prepay for an entire year, your price will go up $24. If you're subscribed as an individual to the All Apps plan, respectively, you'll pay $5 month to month with an annual plan, $7.50 more month to month without any plan, and then $60 more if you prepay annually. It's also important to note that these pricing changes are not totally global. Here's a list of the countries where the pricing changes will impact customers. All right, now let's take a minute and talk about Generative Credits. This is basically now Adobe saying, you know what? All of this kind of Generative Fill, Generative Expand stuff, it's costly. It costs a lot of money in terms of computational power and pure storage. And so now what we're going to do is we've given everyone basically free rein for several months now, and we're going to continue giving you free rein until November 1st. But after that, if you're going to want to use Generative Fill, for example, it will go against a balance or a credit bucket that you'll have. And the amount of credits you get will be determined based on the plan that you're subscribed to. So let's take a look at that. So the way I see Generative Credits is Adobe's way of kind of putting a little bit of control on how often and how much we use its AI tools. So basically, a Generative Credit will be consumed anytime you generate something, or if you click on Load More or Refresh to generate additional options. And these tasks pretty much are covered in, I would say, every Adobe app that has Firefly technology built in. So whether it's Illustrator or Adobe Express or Photoshop or even the Firefly website, if you generate something or you refresh a previous generation, that will count against your credits. The one thing that I don't quite understand is that you won't be debited Generative Credits when you use a generative AI feature defined in the rate table as zero. So I'm not exactly sure what that means. I would like some clarity there, but there are, I guess, some exceptions to when you will or won't be docked a credit. And as a reminder, this doesn't start until November 1st, so you still can take advantage of playing around with all of these tools. It's also important to note that depending on the type of plan you're subscribed to, that'll control how many credits you get every month, and those credits do not roll over from month to month. If you're subscribed to the All Apps plan, then you get the most number of credits. You'll get a total of 1,000 generative credits per month. If you are subscribed to a single app, including the photography 1 terabyte plan, you get 500 credits. And if you're subscribed to the photography 20 gigabyte plan before November 1st, you get 250 credits. And if you sign up after November 1st, you get 100 credits. Same thing goes if you are subscribed to the Lightroom only plan, then you get 100 credits. Now, it's not all doom and gloom if you run out of your monthly credits once they start counting after November 1st. If you're a Creative Cloud subscriber and you run out of all of your generative credits, it does look like you'll still be able to use it, but it'll be slower. And if you're one of those people who just you know you're going to be using these generative credits a lot every month, you can add an additional 100 credits to your account every month for $5 a month. And so those are pretty much the key points that I wanted to cover as part of the price rate increase and the generative credits for Creative Cloud subscribers. If you've got questions, leave them in the comments below. I'll do my best to answer them, but I definitely recommend checking out these support articles as well. Thanks a lot, everyone.